To the channel again. Nice to see you. Today I'm making this video for the coloring book scavenger hunt. I was tagged by the lovely Heather from Color and Felt, so I hope I'm doing it right. And yeah, let's get started. So, number one is a man. I have to say, I don't color a lot of men. I found it difficult because I don't do many. And I picked this one. It is an L fairy, a river fairy, but he is definitely male. So I think he will count as a man. I did him on 10-tone paper. And I used a lot of different pencils. So, and a white gel pen. And I think it's okay. I'm especially proud of the fish. I think they are nice. I was struggling, but I'm happy with them now. So, yeah, that was number one. We go on to number two, and number two is fruit. And I picked an holly. Let me see where this is. Book is the first version of Enchanting Fairies by Barbara Lanza. The book came out in some different I tested some paint on my hand, sorry. Different versions. And this is the first one. And this is a picture that I did a long time ago. And it is done with the first set that came out of the Spectrum Noir color pencils. It was the set before the color blends. And well, the first set I ever had. I wasn't too happy with them and I sold mine, but I was not coloring that long and I was very proud of this picture, especially on my apple, so that's why I picked this picture, because it's adorable and yeah, I'm still proud of it. So that was number two. Number three is a bee. I have not done a lot of bees. I like them in my garden, not in my house. And I did one in Coloriage Wild by Emanuele Connell. And it's this one. And this one is done with pan pastel and pencil and some pan pastel in the background. And I used the glossy accents on the wings of the bees. And yeah, I think they are very cute. So this is my number three bee. It was difficult to find things for every one, every number. Number four is words. I don't do a lot of words, but I picked a flower year from Lila Dully. And there are words in this. So this one has words, it's periwinkle and a wren. And I picked another one because, well, yeah, they are not very big. And this is the bluebell and the white garlic. So there are words. I promised myself last year that I would do one picture every month. And I didn't do it. I stopped doing it at some time. But it's a lovely book and I love flowers, so I have to do more in this one. Number five, Mythical Creature. I picked one from Colomorphia by Kirby Rosen. This is, I have two Kirby Rosen's book. I'm very fond of his art. I think he's an amazing artist, but I find it very difficult to color his pictures. Except for this one. This is my favorite. And this is my version of Medusa. And I did it with mostly Lightfast from Derwent and some light luminance pencils. And there is the Spectrum Noir ink on the eyes. So they are shiny and scary, like they are giving a bright light. The leaves and the card I left uncolored, and I did that on purpose because I wanted them to stand out. And the way to do this was to leave them white. So, yeah. I'm still very happy with this one. There is a video of this one in, I think, 2 or 3 parts on my channel if you want to take a look. So we are on to number 6. And number 6 is Santa. And I have to tell you, I didn't color a Santa. Not one. I have books with Santa in, but I didn't color one. So the closest thing to Santa that I have is this one. And I think he is in a, maybe is a Santa's little helper, and he is an elf, but it's the closest thing to Santa that I have. So I picked this one. I hope it's okay. It's also done on the tone 10 paper. It's by Dawn Davidson. It's a PDF. You can buy it in her Etsy shop, and I love it. I think it came out really nice. The drawing is adorable. The stars are gold. There are glitter on the page. I did the hat with the snowy stuff, so you can feel it. It is like it's, can you see that? There is a lot of texture in the snow, from the snow stuff, so that it looks like fur. And yeah, this is one of my favorite pictures for Christmas. Number 7 is art supplies. That was a difficult one, but I found in Linda Ravenscroft Fairies and Fantasy book number 2, I found this page. I'm doing this with watercolors and it is not finished, but it has art supplies. You have to look very closely, but they are there. So I have to finish this, but I'm loving it. Watercolors and ink tents I'm using for this one. So this is my art supply. And then we go to number 8. And number 8 is a bear. And yeah, you know me, my favorite picture. I did it some time ago in my Japanese book. And this is my bear. And I love him. It is a little bear, but that will count a bear. And this is done with pencil. And with pastels, and then the gel pastels, the sticks, no, pastel pencils, sorry, I'm all confused. Pastel pencils, Prisma, and polish. And I think it's a nice picture, and here is the little bear, I love him. Did it some time ago, but still very happy with it. And I love this book. I don't see many colorists coloring in this book, but it is a lovely book. You can buy it on Amazon Japan. And then we go to number 9. And for number 9 is a pumpkin. So I picked my Yasmin Beckett Halloween coloring book. And I did this one, and it's called A Pumpkin Gift. So I think it will fit the prompt. I used Prismas, a Zig brush, graphite tint, Spectrum Noir ink, dual brush from dual metallic pens from Pentel, I think, I'm not sure. Can you see the Spectrum Noir glitter on there? So I like this one. I think she's nice. So, there's also glitter on one of the pumpkins. Can you? I don't think it will fit. We'll see it on the camera, but I can see it. And then we go to number 10. And number 10 is a licensed character. So, I have my Japanese Disney book, and I only did one. And that's this one. And this is from The Lion King. And it's all done with pen pastel, except for the eyes, the nose, and some stripes here. The rest is all pampastel. Was my first pampastel, full pampastel picture. Stars are a white Posca, so I think it's nice. I think the colors are nice, so yeah. That is my number 10. And then we go to the bonus, and the bonus is your favorite animal. And my favorite animal is a cat. I love cats. So I picked this one. And this one is from Monya Gates. I think it's from her first coloring book. Could be the second, but I think the first. I did it with Prismas. And some gold paint. And some glitter paint. And some pastel for the background. And I think it's a very nice cat. I love him. So that was the last one. And then I have to tag some people. And I had a little note. It's gone. Here it is. I want to tag Amberly Silencia because she is an amazing colorist and she will show us some awesome pictures, I'm sure. And Heather from CBC Coloring Book Club. For this tag, so I will leave it in the description box. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you again. Bye bye for now.